it's so hot in Singapore, then just go to a different country.
Because actually everyone is experiencing it.
Yes, I think in every country there will be an impact also.
And go to Antarctica.
Antarctica?
That's melting.
It might be a little bit too cold. Hello everyone! Welcome to a new episode of Kids Know Best, where we ask kids for advice. I'm Biogirl MJ, and today's topic is all about the environment, so let's meet our team of little green experts.
Hello, my name is Alex, I'm 10 years old.
Hello, my name is Bella and I'm 8.5 years old. We are both green ambassadors.
Today, we're kicking things off by talking about our current trash problem in Singapore. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so first question. In terms of Olympic size swimming pool, really, really big swimming pool, how many swimming pools do you think our trash is able to fill?
I want to say 5.
5 swimming pools? How about you?
5.5.
5.5? Do you guys want to know the answer?
Yeah.
We produce 7.39 million tons of trash, which can fill up to 3,000 Olympic size swimming pools. So it's not 5, it's not 5.5, it's 3,000.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Do you guys know where Singapore's one and only landfill is located?
Nope.
Nope.
I think it's on an island.
Yes, correct, correct, correct.
It's on a small island that's very, very dirty with full of germs.
Actually, in contrary, it's not very dirty. The landfill is all buried underneath. So if you get to visit there, it's called Pulau Semakau. You have to take a boat off the southern part of Singapore. You take a boat out all the way there. It's not dirty at all. So the trash actually buried underneath.
There's also an intertidal walk there.
But what if...
Oh yes, there
is. What if there's such thing? What if pirates come, then they dig it up and they think it's treasure, but it's just trash?
Oh no, then they will start to pollute all the environment.
Oh no.
Why is it important that we bring this number down and reduce our trash in Singapore?
Because soon it will be very, very hot that we can't even wear clothes.
Singapore is a very small place, so we don't have a lot of space to store our trash. And what we sometimes do is we add sand to the water so that there's like more space in the landfill and it can slowly get closer and closer to the city.
Yes, so we actually do that. It's called land reclamation, meaning we put sand into the water to create more land. So if our trash is filling up our landfill, then we need to find new space to store more trash. So sometimes the trash that we throw out there, it ends up in our oceans. So why do you think that is an issue?
My teacher showed me a video of a shark. A baby shark got caught in a plastic container.
What happened to the baby shark?
Because it swam in it, and some of them are transparent, and sometimes straws can get into turtles' noses and they can have serious injuries.
Plastic really takes a very long time to break down, and they will always break down into like really small pieces, so then we cannot clean up, and then like the sea animals will just randomly eat the plastic without even realizing it's there.
We never know that the fish that we eat might contain plastics as well. Now is the big question. You guys have a whiteboard to play with. How would you reduce the trash in Singapore if you could?
I honestly feel like the main problem is plastic bottles, because everyone likes to drink like sweet drinks and that come in plastic bottles.
I think you should use metal bottles. Yeah. So you go to the shop, but then you give your own bottle.
Wow, we've got some really great advice from our team of little experts here. Now let's move on to our next topic. Climate change. What do you guys know about climate change?
It was the hottest day that Singapore has recorded on Saturday. Ironically, I was wearing a sweater.
Do you feel the heat?
Yes, I did, a lot.
If it's so hot in Singapore, then just go to a different country.
Because actually everyone is experiencing it.
Yes, I think in every country there will be an impact also.
And go to Antarctica!
Antarctica?
That's melting.
It might be a little bit too cold. Yes, and the ice caps are melting. You're right, we recently experienced the hottest day in Singapore, 37 degrees. That's almost the same as our body temperature. It's really, really hot.
I hate it.
So why do you think it is important for us to all care about climate change?
Because then soon, if we don't take care of it, then it'll become hotter and hotter and some people might die, I think.
Arctic animals will get extinct.
I keep on telling people not to keep on building buildings because they think that there's so many trees, but soon there won't be enough trees.
Yes. And when there's not enough trees, what do you think will happen?
No more oxygen.
No more oxygen. And also, the trees, they can actually take out all of this carbon dioxide in the air, which is causing the earth to warm up. So if you cut them all down, then these trees won't be able to suck up all the carbon dioxide and the earth will just get hotter and hotter.
Yeah.
Now it's time for the really, really big question that needs you guys to solve. What can we do to slow down climate change?
We can try and reduce our carbon footprint because some people, they like put it to the lowest temperature, and I feel like that's quite wrong.
How do we maybe like reduce the temperature of the earth as a whole?
We put air cons in the sky.
Air cons in the sky? Okay.
Oh, wow.
Would it be as rectangular as the one that we have? Or
this
like
is clouds. And then we have a string here. And this is a pail, a very light pail, and a string here.
A pail on the clouds?
And this is the air con.
What about when it rains?
When it rains, we take away the air con and we replace it with rain and snow.
That sounds really simple to do.
It's a freeze cloud.
So it starts to snow in Singapore?
Yes.
Oh, this sounds really fun.
That would be a dream
come true. I'm not sure if that will
true.
Solve the issue, but that sounds really
yeah,
fun.
Yeah, it does.
Now we shall move on to our final big question. But before we get into that, let's ask our little expert a little bit more about animals. Please draw out your favorite animal.
Oh, okay.
I see eyes. Oh! It is an insect, but it has four legs?
Yeah.
An insect with four legs?
Yeah.
Ah, I think it is a dragonfly that has lost two of its legs.
No, it's a gliding lizard.
Oh, right, it's a Draco lizard. Oh, no wonder it's four legs. Ah, oh my goodness, today I learned. And for yours?
Is it a sausage dog?
No, it's not.
Come on, it looks like a sausage body here.
It's a capybara.
A capybara!
Hey, that's not fair, I've never heard of that before.
They're really, really cute. So how would you feel if your favorite animals went extinct?
I would feel very sad.
I would feel like I have nobody to play with anymore. I really like lizards and insects except cockroaches.
They are like our friends of the forest, friends of the ocean, the final, the biggest of them all. If you can protect all the animals on Earth, how would you guys protect them?
Spread awareness about like illegal poaching of the animals.
I would send all the trucks in the whole entire world to inform every person to not pollute the ocean, the earth, and make sure you don't eat any animal.
Those are really great solutions. Any more?
We make one whole woods.
Okay.
That we do not touch. There's very all the animals inside.
Live in harmony with the other animals?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is like Noah's Ark. Basically,
yeah.
Right?
We can't possibly fit all the animals in the world, right? So maybe we can do it for like the endangered animal.
Ah, well, they can actually, we kind of do something similar. So in the zoos, especially, people are actually trying to breed all of the endangered animals. And some of them, they actually release them into the wild so that they can repopulate.
I just suddenly realized how much I knew about the environment, thinking that it was only something that I was passionate about.
It's very important to protect the environment because soon we won't even have an environment if we don't protect it.
If we don't stop global warming, then all the Arctic animals will be extinct, and I really like them, so we need to try and save them.
I really like speaking to young children because they are full of hope, they are full of energy, and they provide really crazy ideas that actually can translate to real life situations with a little bit of tweak and modifications. Really think big and dream big and always have that hope of the possibility of saving the animals, saving the planet. Whatever happens to the earth, it doesn't just affect the environment or the wildlife, it also affects our livelihoods.
Don't hurt the animals in this earth because one day you will regret it.
We should spread awareness about it to people who don't really know.
Your ripples make waves. So don't think their actions are always too small because all these small ripples, they create big waves of change and you can make an impact together. Thank you for watching this episode.
If you like this video, please comment,
like, share and subscribe.
Bye.
Bye-bye.